Imagine a 747 crashing and killing everyone on board. Now, imagine it happening once a week, every week, spread out over a year. If this were the norm, would you set foot on an airplane? This seems absolutely crazy, but that's how many people human drivers kill in just the US each year. Globally, that number is over 1 million.
Most of the accidents are caused by human error. Drinking and driving, distracted driving, these are all human factors that lead to accidents. So autonomous vehicles can improve safety.
Robot cars hold the promise of saving tens of thousands of lives every year. But that's just one of the ways in which they could utterly transform society.
Welcome to Uprising. Fear not. Robots are already here.
So it's in autopilot now. It's maxing out my speed at 30 miles an hour. And you can see the cars on all sides of me on the control panel here.
Was that the car braking or was that you?
That was the car braking. So I haven't really done anything.
The world of transportation and mobility is being turned upside down. So the question now is, as we go forward, can we direct this towards a better future?
It's hard to imagine a technology with greater capacity to change the world than autonomous cars. In addition to saving lives, it could have massive environmental benefits by reducing congestion and increasing efficiency.
And we have, overall, a city with much less land devoted to roads, much less land devoted to parking, and we use those lands in a way that people will enjoy, whether it's park space or playgrounds. It will mean that we have better transportation, more equitable access.
And those are just the changes we can think of now. Many of the changes it will bring are just unimaginable at this point. Do you think anyone anticipated drive-through restaurants or the suburbs when the automobile was invented? And on the topic of unintended consequences, it's just as possible that autonomous vehicles could actually make things worse.
If our automated cars are personally owned, in other words, if we just take these automated cars and just superimpose them on today's usage patterns and ownership patterns, it will lead to a future in which the cars are used twice as much, they use more energy, they take more space, probably lead to more sprawl. And for the simple reason that if the car is automated, you don't have to pay attention to driving. You can treat the car as a hotel, as an entertainment center, office, and therefore, why wouldn't you spend more time in it?
People can commute for longer distances, creating more congestion, so we have to be cautious about that. That could be a negative impact on cities.
How society uses autonomous cars will determine the kind of future we have. And to get the future we want, we might need to change how we think about cars.
The beautiful picture of sustainable transportation, of automated cars and the future being positive, depends on two factors. One is that we move beyond personal ownership of vehicles, and two, that the vehicles are pooled. In other words, more than one person is riding in them at a time. Pooling really is the answer.
Optimus Ride is a company focused on what we call geofenced autonomy, so the ability to deploy vehicles at low speed, 25 miles per hour or less, in a geofenced area. That could include an industrial park like the Brooklyn Navy Yard that we're in. It could include a university campus. These are all geofenced locations. So we think that the introduction of self-driving vehicles can start in those markets, and over time we can expand the level of complexity that we go into.
There are already self-driving cars of various levels. There's automatic braking, there's adaptive cruise control, there are even cars that will change lanes and maneuver in traffic or park for you. And more people are adapting to car sharing and pooling through human-driven services like Lyft. Society is making little moves in the right direction.
The beautiful future that I envision does depend on automation. But this future, it's not all automated cars. It includes the scooters and electric bikes and walking, buses and rail. It's a vision that moves away from personal car ownership to a suite of mobility services.
And the other thing to think about too is that this is going to be a generational thing. We're not going to have self-driving vehicles everywhere next week. It will take a generation. It'll take 25 to 30 years to do that. The ability to have a fully autonomous vehicle, which is able to drive in every condition, that's more than 10 years away.
The car was invented to move us around, to free us from other limitations. But in the last 100 years, it has become its own sort of prison, keeping us locked up in freeways and searching for parking spots. It also puts us in a tremendous amount of danger. Autonomous vehicles offer us the opportunity to escape that prison. Will we be smart enough to take it? Thanks for watching this episode of Uprising. Please like and subscribe. It really helps us grow our channel, as well as tell more stories about people who are thinking differently and changing the world.